Well, it's 2013. Beaver Bytes are continuing, except they're going a little more high-tech now. I've kind of had the idea for a while to take it beyond just plain old paper and, you know, practice what I preach. And the old Beaver Bytes were cool, and they were a great way to get started. But I think it needs to get a lot more interactive and media-based. So got several things planned. I'll try to make this quick. Your time is important. One thing you'll notice is in the information on the YouTube video that I sent out, when you're actually on YouTube on my account for each Beaver Byte, in the info, the memo section below the information, I'll put links to articles and things that I refer to. So, hey, thanks for checking it out. Well, a couple quick notes, reminders. I'm getting this information off the 21st Century website, the Beaver Learning one that we spoke of at the end service. We have our next iPad meeting next Friday. That's Friday, January 11th, and that will be in the high school in the red and white room, and that's going to be from 2:45 to 4 o'clock. There's a new segment or piece that I'd like to work on, and I need help. I need volunteers. And it's kind of like a book talk. I'm sure many of you have heard of book talks, or you've had those in your class. This is an app talk, and it's from our staff, from the high school staff. And basically what we're going to do is we're going to, when you feel comfortable, when you have an app that you've used and you can kind of see different ways to use it, I'd love you to email me, talk to me, and we'll do a 3 to 5 minute quick app talk. And that'll consist of me taping you, speaking, and I'll bring my iPad/iPhone, and I'll tape you speaking, and also it won't just be your face. It'll also be close-ups of the app, and the big thing is 3 to 5 minutes. You know, everyone's time is valuable, and I'll host it on my YouTube account and embed it on the wiki. So again, that's the app talk. Please help volunteer. I don't want this just to be a Mr. Cunningham and myself thing. I'd like everybody to get involved. This is our thing. So as kids are all coming back and ready to go, please continue doing a great job with those agendas. Have the students sign the agenda no matter what. If they go to the restroom, if they need to go to the office, please, no little sticky notes, no alternatives. If they don't have an agenda, send them down to my office and it'll be recorded that they don't have an agenda, or I'll sell them a new one. But please help me be consistent with that. I think it's been great, and we need to keep pushing it. We're halfway through, and I really appreciate everything you guys have done. It's been great, and the agendas have really kind of helped a lot of small issues. So if you're on the 21st Century Learning Beaver Local site, and you go to the Navigator on that wiki, and you scroll down, you're going to see... Let's see, I can't find it myself. There it is, Lessons Remixed with iPad. All right. As you can see, I have a list of all the iPad Phase 1 people. And if you click on any of them, you would be able to see... let's see. You can see the lesson. And then you can see how it's been remixed. All right, and then you can see my comments. Now, that I enjoy making comments, but I love you guys to make comments also. I'd like you to get on. Many of you have said that you've popped on and looked at other people's, lesson, but you didn't make comments. So please let the person know that you're checking it out. And you can see this is Mrs. Ash, and she remixed hers. And again, there's a comment at the bottom, but it's just my comment. So I want to encourage you to do that. Also, your lesson is due, today's the 2nd, the 3rd, so tomorrow by midnight. If you have any questions, come and ask me. I know a few of you have turned that in already, so January 3rd, I know that says 2nd, But the third is when that's due, so make sure you turn that in. And I'm going to be commenting on those again, and we're really going to take one and two, and I have something planned for that and kind of to extend it. Because we have a couple things going on, and I'll talk more about that later, but just to kind of hint at that, it's a combination of not only using technology, but it's also 21st century skills, and they aren't, you know, both of them need practice. You need to practice with both of them. And that'll take all of us working together, examples and practice. So scheduling's coming up, and you'll see some information about that. You know, that's real important. Obviously, you probably got the email from Mr. Cunningham. We have a new guidance counselor. Many of you probably know him. And that's going to be pretty exciting. We're going to really get ahead of the scheduling and really make this year's scheduling, you know, the best that it's been. This is my YouTube account, my professional account, and I put a link in Twitter. So if you go on my Twitter account, and I literally have a link to this, and then you can bookmark it. But this is where I'm going to be hosting Beaver Bytes. I obviously haven't uploaded the one I'm working on now, but for example, here is our third Beaver Local iPad meeting. And I'm going to hit pause, just so it doesn't speak over me. But in this area, I guess it's going anyways. In this area down here is where I'm going to have info and some of the articles and things I've spoken about. So go ahead and get in there and subscribe to me. And of course, I would encourage you to make your own YouTube account. And it's simple. It's really, really easy. And I can help you with that, or several other people can too. I wanted to mention a couple things, articles, and I'm going to have the link on that YouTube. One is 20 apps to check out for 2013. There are several really great ones. The other one that I really liked, and I have it pulled up over here, is, there we go. 16 Flip Classrooms in Action right now. This is, I think, a really great read, and it's talking about some teachers that are actually doing it. For example, pre-AP geometry explains where, how it's happening, some links and some info, European history. Same format, AP Calculus, again, they flip their classrooms and it gives a little info on how that's working. One that I'm hoping to continue and to get some help with, teaching teachers, which is, you know, professional development. And this is someone who's flipping that. I know Mr. Cunningham and I are going to be working on that for our staff meeting. And a foe flipped fourth grade, that's definitely interesting, you have to read that one. That's in Florida. Digital Media Design and Criticism. Very cool class. I'd love to get that at Beaver Local. Group Learning and Exploration. Government Economics and AP U.S. History. 6th grade math. Moodle Alternatives. And it kind of goes on for a while. But I'd love you to check this out. I know some of you, it has your subject matter. And again, the name of this article, and I'll have the link. 16 foot classrooms in action right now. And this will take us past our philosophical discussion today and see something actually being done now, which I know is a big concern for all of us. Check that out. The other one I wanted to mention is 5 Reasons the iPad Will Stay King in the Classroom. And it talks about it being a new device which creates new opportunity. It can do things and make students and teachers think in completely different ways. Talks about workflow. That's something we'll really be talking about in the future, is the idea of workflow and how that, you know, functions. That'll be important for us. The ecosystem, the connectivity of all the different devices, it kind of goes in between that. Obviously, the cloud in the middle. And some of us have a couple of these devices, but you know, yeah, the laptop, iPhone, the iPad, the Apple TV, which would be important for us, and then the iMac, and the connectivity between all those, and the new renewed focus on education. aspirational, think different, kind of a great theme for us. So again, that's a great article, and the name of that article, 5 Reasons the iPad Will Stay King in the Classroom. So that's a great professional read, and I will have that in the YouTube info. So, well, that's the first Beaver Bite. I hope you enjoy this new format. I know it's a little shaky, and I'm a little ummy and kind of rambly, but I'll work on that, and hopefully we can get some other people's face on here so you don't have to stare at mine. I know that's tough. I enjoyed it, and I'm glad school. I enjoyed the break, but I'm glad we're all back. So please comment, send me emails, talk to me in the hall. I'd love to come in and work with you, talk with you after class, before school, after school, anything we need to do for our students. I'll see you next time.